talent is something special, a flavor that sticks out more than you would see in the average person.
Like me.
Like you.
Like you. Bob is now in the process of producing a Broadway show. What's the name of that show again?
A Strawberry Grew on an Apple Tree.
And how old are you, Bob?
21.
21. How do you find dealing with the industry at such a tender age, dealing with all these big-timers when you're only 21?
At times it can be trying, but for the most part it's fun, because a lot of the clients feel that dealing with someone younger than them, you can speak easier. And the people in the business themselves, the David Merricks and the Joe Franklins and so forth, have no problem in communicating because there's no inferior or superior.
What do you call your company, Bob?
Capri Productions.
Capri. Listen, one of my proteges, besides Marie Alvarez, is a young man named Brian Wilde. He'll be on tomorrow's show. He's done a tribute to Errol Flynn, a record. I want you to... Eddie, what goes through your mind, Eddie, alongside the young producer and the young comedian?
Well, let's talk about the comedian first.
Right, right.
It's really, really fantastic and weird that we should be talking about this now, because 6 weeks ago I started in a club just presenting comedy only. And I can say one thing. This lady will lay them out. You ignore the possibility of thinking about her age. You just listen to her. She's fantastic.
Marie, what do you want to say?
I wake up in the morning, I read the obituary notice, my name is not in it, so I get dressed. Then I call the suicide prevention lead, they told me to go ahead. So I shot myself in the breast and I broke my kneecap.
She called the Better Business Bureau and said, please make me some better business, right? Things are quiet. I would like you to meet Peter Prescott. Peter, what are any trends in magazines or trends in food? Bring us up to date on the life of food and wine.
Trends in food, common sense,
right.
American food, regional food, seasonal food, stuff you can buy around the corner at a specific time of year. Not overeating, obviously, and Marie is a great example of good living, not overeating.
No, you got me before the Benzedrine wore off.
I've got a man on tomorrow who wrote a book called Diets Don't Work. You know, and on a much broader base, I always wonder, why are we such an overweight nation, always so compulsive about losing weight? Why, you know, I wonder, was it always like that?
No, I don't think it was always like that. We tend to be in a terrific hurry, and we tend to eat unsensible food, quick food, junk food, if you will. And in the old days, people lived off the land, people lived off sensible food and didn't abuse themselves. And he's right, diets don't work, because we tend to diet too quickly and the weight comes pouring back on. If you do it gradually and eat sensibly, obviously you're going to keep slim.
Let me ask these two men on the end before I get back to Marie. Do men cook nowadays, as in your case? Do you cook, Eddie, and do you cook, Bob Cipriano? Starting with Eddie?
No, with me, only when I have to.
Eddie does not cook. Bob?
I don't even know how to make an egg.
I bet
Marie,
you do.
Marie, what's
no,
your...
I'm all right. I have so many gallstones, I sit in the rocking chair, it sounds like a crap game.
That's Eddie's next hit, Shake, Rattle, and Roll, right?
I'm going to look for her.
Boy, if you don't use her on a Friday night, Eddie, you're missing a good bet. Well, do men cook generally, Mr.
Yeah.
Prescott?
Yeah, a great deal now. 50% of